Hello, my fellow Homo sapiens. It's 10 o'clock in the morning when I'm filming this Groundhog Day. So I thought that I would start my day of celebratory fun. By watching Groundhog Day with Bill Murray, the original. It came out in 1993 on February 12th. It is fitting because February is the love month, and February is also when Groundhog Day is, which is the second, which is today. But it turned out to be a blizzard today. And so for the first time in my recollection, Groundhog Day has been postponed. Punxsutawney Phil, that's the groundhog's name in case you didn't know, will not be coming out and making an appearance till later this week to see if he sees a shadow or not. Let's go back over 20 years to what I personally think is a pretty darn good movie, at least my recollection. It's been a long time since I watched it. It's the best kind of party is when you just cuddle up, get cozy, stay cozy, and settle in for a movie, something relaxing. And so I'm going to watch Groundhog Day.
Together at high altitudes and cross some snow. Going out on a limb now. Not going to hit us here. Pittsburgh, going to push off and hit altitude.
I think it's a nice story. Comes out. He looks around. He wrinkles up his little nose. He sees his shadow. He doesn't see his shadow. It's nice. People like it.
You are Udo, aren't you? You know, people like blood sausage, too. People are morons.
To him, the rat talks back. And then they tell us what's going to happen.
Oh, isn't he cute?
You like your guys with the prominent upper teeth?
No.
Come on, boys, you're playing yesterday's tape.
This week, the 4th, among other days, happens to be Wear Red Day, which is fitting for February. I would think it would be next week versus this week, because this would have been a perfect one for the week of Valentine's. Thank you. wearing it with boots. I even painted my nails to match. Really going with the red theme. I gained 10 pounds. This used to be a sack on me, but now it fits me quite nicely. Was it worth the weight gain? Chronic illness. Antipsychotics, antidepressants created 10 pounds more of me. I'm adjusting. Body dysmorphia. When I see myself filling out a dress that I could otherwise wear, you can come to two conclusions. The glass is half full or the glass is half empty. You can be like, oh my God, this thing used to be like a garbage bag on me. It used to just hang off of me. To, it fits me like a glove. I must be huge. How much have I put on since then? Or you can take a look at yourself and realize, you're a fully fledged adult woman. And fully fledged adult women are meant to have some curves. One of my favorite classical songs. If you never headbang to classical music, you know what you're missing. Oh, I was about to turn the classical music off, you guys, gals, everyone else, but this happens to be Fur Elise, my favorite classical song. So I guess today we're just having a sophisticated party. So, other than dress in red, Groundhog's Day. Check. And carrot cake, which is for very many, give or take. For me, it is going to be my birthday cake this year. And I have yet to figure out how I'm going to incorporate it. Because we are currently in the midst of a blizzard. Since today is carrot cake day, and I don't have a carrot cake,
It's about the only cake that I will eat, and I do not have one. This is very sad for me. So, I decided to make my own. Let's party! Woo! Cake, cupcake, plate, we're halfway there. Carrot, smash it in there. Thought I was gonna stick another cake on my face, didn't ya? Now, to make this a little more palatable, Freddy Whip. Carrot cake. Are you jealous? Do you want some? Do you want some of my carrot cake? Okay, let's put both my sides of my hair behind my head for this. I gotta eat it from this side so you guys can tell I actually ate the carrot too. It's a little hard to chew. We're gonna finish this off. I suggest you try it. Wasn't as bad as I would have surmised. Putting a whole raw carrot on top of a chocolate cake. Almost as good as the real thing. Listening to classical. Being sophisticated. You know, it's not sophisticated. Tater tots. They're loved by many. I don't have any tater tots in my house because I don't like tater tots. Please don't judge me. I know a lot of people love their tater tots. Restaurants started having specific dishes just for tater tots. They come in all flavors. The last time I had a tater tot was on the school lunch tray when I was in elementary. I heard him describe them once as, cook them so that if you throw them at the ground, they shatter. That's how crispy I want my tater tots. If you don't feel like putting on a red gown, and listening to some classical music, lighting candles and pretending like you're sophisticated when you know you're not. I know I'm not. You might be. I'm not. Pretending that we're sophisticated, then you can decide instead to stay in your jammies like I had on while I watched my movie. Wake up, go to your freezer, pull out those hash browns, throw them in your microwave, and go to town. Because I don't have any tater tots to eat, to juggle, to share. Instead, since we're having a sophisticated party this evening, We'll do what adults do, and we'll talk about facts and history, so that when you're with your highbrow friends, you can impress them with your etiquette and your knowledge of tater tot history. The tater tots were originally made from French fry scraps. Number two. Number three. The name Tater Tot is trademarked. Are you ready? Is this thrilling? Is this party exciting? This is an adult party. Adult parties aren't exciting. Tater Tots have different names around the world. Tater Tots are potatoes. Tater Tots. Like baby potatoes. Tater Tots were invented in 1953. Americans alone consume 70 million pounds of tater tots each year. This number translates to a roughly daily consumption of 192,000 tater tots. That's a fact for you. These slicing and dicing machines that cut the potatoes into fries had trouble and would create these little slivers like sawdust when you're cutting boards of irregularly shaped chunks of potato. Because of this impediment, someone had the brilliant idea of taking these scraps, squashing them together, throwing them in the deep fryer, and calling them a new product. If this is not your way, young Padawan, you can always step outside yourself and see if you see your own shadow. Perhaps it's not the groundhog that's magic. Perhaps it's the day. You know what is my style? Hemp is my style. Hemp is a pretty spectacular. It can be made into rope. Sturdy building material. Can be derived into mind-soothing chemicals. And like CBD, they have begun to insert hemp into everything. I don't notice a difference, but with a chronic illness, you are willing to try anything. Hemp seeds are technically nuts. Hemp cultivation dates back 8,000 years. By weight, hemp seeds contain as much protein as beef. Hemp paper is more durable than wooden paper. Hemp can grow without pesticides. In 1941, the Ford Company built a plastic car made of hemp. Hemp fiber can be used to make everything from skateboards to decks. Hemp can eliminate toxins and radioactive material. That's kind of cool. Hemp captures carbon emission and is a sustainable crop, so we can solve climate change if we just grow more hemp. One, two, three. Hemp, gummy for me. I just helped to save a bee. This is the kind of party you'd get up and leave, right? Can't help it. They're not always going to be winners. Periodically, these celebratory videos are going to be bad. But I gave a gold star for trying. You might run across this. The periodic table. It's split in black and white, and it looks even more stuffy and sophisticated and educational. We're learning lots of fun facts today. The 7th is National Periodic Table Day. You may remember this from Nightmares of High School. Element 88266, francium. And figure out what a tater tot is called in France. To keep this nice and sophisticated, a tater tot in French, which I cannot speak, just giving you a warning, is galettes de pommes de terre. What about hemp? Hemp in France is called chanvrerie. Chanvrerie. I think I pronounced that a little better. Just a little. So by Shunri. Don't expect to get high like Mary Jane because they are not the same. But if you do, you will see one or two more
honey. Those of you who do not know, charcuterie is a wood-plated selection of tiny cheese pieces, which you may recall from Cheese Lover's Day. But today is more select than Cheese Lover's Day. This cheese apparently deserves its own day. Maybe by the end of the year. Between all the cake and the pie and the real life holidays, the charcuterie. I will have gained another 10 pounds. This time was also a prime opportunity to miss a can of whipped cheese product. They can't call canned cheese, i.e. cheese whiz, cheese. But it does come in cheddar, and today is cheddar day, and soon plated on my charcuterie board will be a sampler platter that we will enjoy on our periodic table. Get it? Get it? Oh! I know it's upside down and in reverse, but so's life. I know we already did this. Apparently, Americans love their cheese because there's Cheese Lover's Day, and now there is Cheddar Day, which cheddar happens to be one of my personal favorites. I have 3 samples of cheddar, which I have already nibbled into because, as I mentioned in the previous video, I love the cheese. I'm like a little mouse, except they like peanut butter better. I got something different and fancy for our party. Cabot. It is a complex, wildly intense, sharp cheddar experience. And this one. Smooth, creamy, and Italian inspired. That's nutty, like Parmesan, in a beautiful wrapper. We eat half with our eyes. And to balance the high and low brow, we have generic sliced singles. It is real cheese, not cheese product, though. Not bad. Nothing I would buy again. Over here, we have the Cabot Vermont Sharp Cheddar Cheese. Complex, wildly intense sharp cheddar experience. Big advertising. And all these are real products, not with false oils or anything like that in it. So. I prefer this to that, but I would say that cheese is about as wild as this party. Not an exhilarating experience thus far. And here, folded into 4 squares, piled in a crumpled heap, is our extra sharp generic cheddar cheese. toss up between that and that. Actually, the beautiful black one, which was again, Sartori, not really a fan. Cabot, it's okay, but not $6, more okay than the off-brand cheddar. Let's do a combo. Better. Better mixed together. I personally would not endorse any of these cheeses. If I had to pick one between the three, it would actually be off-brand cheese slice. Total miss. Score. Finally. I have a habit of compulsively chewing gum when I'm anxious, and I chew gum my entire shift of work. So I have gum sticks with me at all times, because I'm high strung and I'm high class. I think the more I stick in my mouth, the more likely I'm going to be able to blow a bubble. So let's go on that principle. This is chewing gum, this isn't really bubble gum. Major difference. Chewing gum flavor tends to last longer. And it is more intended to be chewed. It doesn't have the same elasticity that bubble gum has. It's actually bubble gum day. So something like a plastic tasting, non-flavored Bazooka Joe would do you better if you want to make bubbles. Just kidding. Oh my gosh. What happened to you? Poor duck. He's got his wing in a sling and a boo-boo on his head. And I just got back out of bed. I took a nap in the middle of filming this because that's the kind of party this is. Which is probably what our politicians are doing right now. Despite that they're showing up. Or perhaps they're playing card games or Candy Crush. More like Candy Crush. Politicians don't get along. But they do show up and hesitate pushing laws forward or accomplishing any work because they're in between terms. And that's pretty lame. Like my doc. He's lame. Poor little thing. Lame duck. It's this week. So can expect. Politicians to get together again and accomplish, well, about as much as they usually do. My second favorite classical song. Moonlight Sonata. I have out my periodic table again. And even though I threw him out of my party, he joined a 12-step program and made amends. He's cleaned up his life. So I'm going to welcome him back to the table. Because we forgive. It's the right thing to do. Besides being my favorite classical song conductor, these, my friends, are chopsticks. I could have played chopsticks to chopsticks, but I thought that would be a little too much. Because not only is it lame duck day, it's also National Chopstick Day. So I thought the sophisticated party need to be brought up a notch. A throwback to our childhood of bobbing for apples. One, two, three, four, five, six. Pretty good, not bad. I'm pretty good with chopsticks, apparently. I will reinsert them. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Look how cute these little guys are. Wee, baby! Little ducks. I thought I would bring it back down to something you have probably not done since you were a child. This is going to be much easier because I personally could never get my teeth into the freaking apples. We're going to bob for ducks because that's a party activity. One, two, three, four. Let's see how long it takes me to. One. Someone took my position, and I don't feel in the condition to do any work. Splash!
This is why the music died. But the levee was dry.
I knew if I had my chance that I could make those people dance, and maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver with every paper I delivered. Bad news on the doorstep. I couldn't take one more step. I can't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride. Something touched me deep inside the day the music died. So bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, "This will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die." Did you know the book of love? And did you have faith in God above? Bible tells you so. Do you believe in rock and roll? Can music save your mortal soul? And can you teach me how to dance real slow? Well, I know that you're in love with him, cause I saw you dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. Then I did those rhythm and blues. I was a lonely teenage drunken buck with a pink carnation and a pickup truck. I knew I was out of luck. The day the music died. Beautiful song, love it. But wrote based on the unfortunate plane crash death into the side of a mountain of very famous and prominent musicians.
It's Fly a Kite Day. So I thought I'd play outside in a blizzard flying a kite.
This time, we actually want to go all the way with intention.
Wow, the octopus tail on this kite is very long. And there may be wind chill, but there's not much wind. So we're going to see what we can do. This is what we're working with, folks. Hard to get a run in the snow. Saw it. I'm gonna tip it up a little bit. Woo! There is some wind here.
He's just a big wad. He still wants to fly. He's trying. But it's just a big tangled mess. So I think that'll be the end, the maiden voyage of the Optimus Kite. In my first adventure at the traditional winter sport of kite flying. For now. Now it's time to bring this back in the house and do something equally festive. Just flying a giant octopus. Yeah. I don't go out in the winter. I don't go out much at all. I can't even recall the last time I've flown a kite, and I know I've never flown one in the winter. That's just ridiculous. And I got the octopus going pretty good there for a minute, but then he got all tangled, and I'm gonna have to have my boyfriend untangle that because I made quite the mess of him. But that was joy. There are many a joke about going postal that I won't make. Ooh, it's hard to spin in an apartment this tiny. Mailman Appreciation Day. And I went out and got a card. Specifically. For Mailman Appreciation Day. It was shaped like a dog. And the rest is history. And so is my card. I left it at my boyfriend's house. In Heart Association, I have these address stickers that I have never used. So it's got hearts, that's my heart reference, and my address. And on the Valentine's Day stickers, I got this one. It doesn't say anything, so it's not like obscene. But it's got a letter on it, which I thought was appropriate, with hearts to match my sticker. What? Of course I had to use the periodic table. Because I do not have my doggy car to put it in. I won't put it in my mailbox until next week when I have reclaimed my cart. Let's see what I wrote. February 4th is National Thank a Mail Carrier Day. Weather. Rain, sleet, or snow. Ha ha ha. Bad jokes. I'm full of bad jokes. You knew that or not. So this is just a note to say thank you and all carriers for all you do. You are appreciated. And I will give him this. Lovely little note. With a sticker. And he already knows my address, so I'm not doing anything. Some cellos. And I will fold it up nicely. Put it in a card that is shaped like a dog. Because that would just be funny. Now, I would say we had a pretty good day. We woke up and watched Groundhog's Day. We played some games. Like bobbing for lame ducks. And
did a lot of other things, like classical and stuff. We learned the history of hemp and tater tots. We've done a lot. We even went outside to play. I'd say it's been a pretty good day. Aside from that carrot cake, if that carrot cake left, plus all the other food days we've had since January, in a sore spot, left a bitter taste in your mouth, it's okay. Because January 9th is Tuesday day, and I have a brand new bottle of unopened oral analgesic for you. Although I do suggest you don't celebrate this day unless you have to, because toothaches are really no fun. Not nearly as fun as flying a kite in the snow in a blizzard in 0 degree temperatures. Coming back in and changing into warm and cozy clothes. But if you don't take care of your teeth, those little decisions we make every day, everybody knows, or if you eat too much sugar, too many slices of carrot cake, you just might have to take some Ambisol. Why on earth would they have a National Toothache Day? I don't know. That's not how I really intend to finish out my holiday. I woke up cozy, I watched a movie, I played some games, I learned some things. I listened to classical music and learn the origins of some other music. I even learned a couple of words in French.
Well then,
if there's children in the room, now would be the time to ask them to scram. There's a wonderful way to close out the day, but your little kitty shouldn't hear. It is on the 5th, but we're putting all together one big day-long celebration. It is World Nutella Day, not just National Nutella Day. World Nutella Day. They have a World Nutella Day, but it goes great with another holiday on the 5th, which is why your kitties had to leave. Shower with a friend day. If you don't do it today, I suggest you do it soon. Sometime in your life, put it on your bucket list. Smother each other in Nutella. And then clean it off in the shower. Or smother yourself in Nutella and clean it off in the shower. This is really a holiday. Happy Obscure Holidays. Number 5, I think. I think. And I think we're gonna call it. We're gonna call it done. Love you guys. I got nothing else. I mean, I do. I've got props all over the place and, I found some oversized bubble wrap. Freaks out the cat. I got a lot of stuff I could do. But I think we're good.